In this learning module, we will take a sweeping look at the ways in which you can interactively limit data displayed in Spotfire visualizations and drill down to get more information about items of interest. Although expressions, in-database data connections, and load-on-demand data tables may also be configured to achieve data-limiting goals, our primary focus in this module will be upon the interactive features of marking and filtering. The best way to think about this topic, conceptually, is to first imagine all rows of the data in the underlying data table being represented in a visualization. We will interact to define those subsets of data in which we are most interested. Marking is one way of interacting with items in visualizations to identify a subset of data of interest. You can also adjust filter settings in order to isolate a subset of interest. So far, the picture is pretty simple. However, Spotfire also provides the ability to define more than one marking and the ability to define more than one set of adjusted filter settings, known as filtering schemes. So the picture gets a little more complex, but still manageable. Now we need to factor in that some visualization configuration options can be applied which allow you to leverage more than one marking to identify data of interest, thus presenting the rows defined by the intersection of the two marking subsets. Additionally, multiple filtering schemes may be applied to limit data, thus identifying rows which meet all of the filtering criteria in both filtering schemes. The visual impact of marking and filtering may also overlap, further complicating the picture. And additional markings and filtering schemes are possible, adding further flexibility as well as the potential for additional complexity to the analysis document. Fortunately, there is a dialogue which provides control over the color and name of markings which are defined in a given analysis document, as well as the names of different filtering schemes which have been created. Under the Edit menu, the Document Properties dialog is the location to remember for evaluating and editing these defined data subsets. Let's see these markings and filterings in action in a demonstration. Use Open File and navigate to the file with Subsets Overview in the title. Click Open and agree to the terms and conditions of use. For this demonstration, a very simple example data table has been chosen. It contains only 12 rows, each of which defines a company which sells either collectibles or technology-related products. For each company, market share, market growth, sales, and profit values have been collected. Those values have been related in these two plots, which we can use to discuss two common mechanisms of immediate interactive drill down. Tooltip information boxes can be configured to display the desired information upon mouse over of a visualization item, like a marker, line, bar, or pie segment. Or, in some visualization types, labels may be configured to display values from the underlying data table only when data is marked. Since we have brought up marking, let's click where there are no markers in order to clear this marking and proceed to the next page. Here, we have two visualizations which are configured to use the original marking. When we mark items in one visualization, they change to a green color and are also marked in the other visualization, which is also configured to use the original marking. However, note that the two lower visualizations are not impacted by this marking. If we mark in this visualization, markers turn blue because the visualization has been assigned marking 1. In this visualization, markers turn red when marked, a visual indication that marking 2 has been assigned. So, on this page, we have identified three different subsets of data through marking: the original marking, marking 1, and marking 2. Let's click where there are no markers in order to clear each marking and move on to the next page. On this page, a copy of the two visualizations which share the original marking are presented. In addition, there's a table visualization which has been configured as a details visualization. What is a details visualization, you might ask? Well, it is a configuration option which is available for all visualization types in which the marking in other visualizations determines the data to be displayed. In this case, we have a table visualization. Therefore, marking in either visualization will populate this table with the rows of marked data. This behavior is identical to that of the Details on Demand panel. However, there is more flexibility in where one can place a table visualization on the page. Take note of the fact that the legend indicates that this table is limited by the original marking. If we proceed to the next page, the legend indicates that this table has been configured as a details visualization, which is limited by two markings, marking 1 and marking 2. In this case, marking the data in the upper left quadrant of this visualization will have no impact upon the table, because only the marking 1 subset has been defined. There is currently no data in the marking 2 subset. If we mark the 4 highest sales and profit companies, the table is populated with only 2 rows of data. These 2 rows represent the intersection between marking 1 and marking 2 subsets. In other words, those companies which are marked in both scatter plots. We can use the mouse over tooltip interactions in order to determine which markers are associated with which row in the details table visualization, and the highlighting or outline which appears on rows and markers as we mouse over may aid in that association of data across visualizations. If we move on to the next page, a copy of the scatter plots using marking 1 and marking 2 respectively have been placed on this page. In addition, a bar chart appears, which counts the rows or number of companies in each category assigned to each marking subset. As we change the marking, the bar chart adjusts in order to relate the changing count in each category. Note that this bar chart is not a details visualization per se. Instead, it employs the subsets variable in order to define the different colored bars, thus allowing you to make a direct evaluation and comparison of the data subsets which are defined by each of these markings. On the next page, 2 identical plots have been configured. However, each one is set to respond to a different filtering scheme. Therefore, if we adjust filters associated with filtering scheme 1 by removing the companies selling collectibles or limiting the data to only those companies with higher market growth values, only the top visualization is impacted. If we adjust filtering scheme 2 by removing technology companies, it will impact only the bottom visualization. Thus, by making filter adjustments in different filtering schemes, we have isolated different subsets of data for display in the visualizations on this page. If we return the filtered out categories to the visualizations in both filtering schemes, but leave filtering scheme 1 set to limit the market growth range, when we proceed to the next page, you can see that another bar chart has been configured. This one also applies the subsets variable to color bars. However, this time it is the different subsets which are defined by filtering schemes, which determines the subset categories. Again, adjusting filter settings in each filtering scheme will impact the height of bars associated with that subset. On the final page of this analysis, if we clear the marking in each of these plots, please take note that the legend of the bar chart indicates that this is a details visualization, which is limited by 2 markings. However, an OR label appears between the markings. Therefore, we can mark data in this plot, and it will immediately populate this details visualization, because marking 2 is not required. Either marking subset will populate this details visualization with rows of data. So when we add values to the marking 2 subset, the details visualization now includes all companies identified with either marking 1 or marking 2, or both. Finally, it is important to remind you that marking and filtering may define subsets which overlap. So, which of those values are visible can change if we apply filtering, like removing the collectibles category. The subsets defined by marking 1 and marking 2 still remain. However, some of the values have been hidden from view due to the application of this filtering scheme. Before we leave this analysis example, let's go to the Edit menu and launch the Document Properties dialog. Under the Markings tab, we can select any of the markings and click the Edit button in order to change the marking name. We'll enter stars and change the color. We'll make the marking gold. Let's also edit marking 2 to have a more meaningful name, like cash cows, and click OK. Under the Filtering Schemes tab, we could use the Rename button to edit the names of each filtering scheme such that they make sense in our scenario. Perhaps these filters are being adjusted by 2 separate analysts on our team, Joe Schmo and Jane Doe. When we click OK, you may find that meaningful names make interacting with and interpreting these different markings and filtering schemes a little bit easier. Regardless though, this demonstration has related a lot of information from the examination of such a simple data table. Therefore, let's review the major learning points revealed during this demonstration. We discovered that immediate drill down is available when we hover our mouse over an item in a visualization. A tooltip information box may be displayed, and the highlighting which outlines a row, line, marker, or pie segment may assist us in relating information across visualizations. In addition, labels may be configured to display information selectively for the marked data subset. And while each visualization is assigned a single marking, different visualizations may be assigned different markings, which result in distinct and different subsets of data. Those markings may be used to limit data in a visualization which has been configured as a details visualization. This is fairly straightforward when only a single marking is involved. However, it becomes more complex as multiple markings may define the data to be displayed in the details visualization as either the values which are marked in both marking subsets or values which are marked in either marking subset. An alternative approach to displaying subsets defined by marking is to apply the subsets variable to a visualization property. And marking is not the only way to define subsets. Different filter settings, known as filtering schemes, can be applied to visualizations or pages. These also define subsets which can be differentiated by the subsets variable on visualizations.